In 2008, Compassion in World Farming revealed that young calves were being taken all the way from Wales, Cumbria and Cheshire to Spain, on journeys lasting anything from 50 to over 100 hours. Every year since 2006, UK dairy farmers have exported thousands of young male calves to the continent to be reared for veal. Until recently, these animals were exported through Dover. But in May 2011, the trade switched to Ramsgate. By filing Freedom of Information requests, we found out that around 9,000 calves have been exported via the port of Ramsgate. Compassion in World Farming decided to look into this new route. In December 2011, our investigators picked up trucks carrying animals at a motorway service station. One is carrying calves. Our investigators confirmed these calves were British from their UK ear tags. We found that some of the drinking devices on the truck were defective. This is a serious problem. In the morning, the trucks drove in convoy to Ramsgate. Our investigators were able to tip off the authorities that the truck with the calves had water drinking devices that weren't working and a defective brake light. Also that some of the calves had nasal discharges. As the trucks were loading onto the former Soviet tank carrier, the Jolene, we learned that the defective drinking devices had been fixed. In a subsequent trail in April 2012, we waited in Calais as the Jolene arrived. We followed this truck, which was carrying UK calves. The animals had come from Devon and had already been travelling over land and sea for 15 hours by this point. There are 166 calves on board. Sometimes there'd be many more, with conditions being much more crowded. Calves have a very high need to suckle, but in the absence of their mothers, they try to suckle almost anything. This includes the tails of other calves. Eventually, after travelling for 20 hours, they arrive at an official resting place. Here, the calves are unloaded. The next afternoon, they are reloaded and the long journey to Spain resumes. The driver shortchanges the calves on their rest period, giving them only 22 and a half hours rest, rather than the full 24 hours required by law. Young calves should not be sent on such long journeys. Scientific research shows that they can't really cope with transport. Their immune systems are not fully developed, and they're not able to properly control their body temperature. This makes them vulnerable to both heat and cold. The truck continues the long journey south through the night. Eventually, late the next morning, they arrive at a farm just north of Barcelona. Unloading begins. The calves appear unsteady and a little confused. This is hardly surprising, as in all, the journey from Devon has taken 59 hours. Compassion in World Farming's supporters, together with Kent Action Against Live Exports and Thanet Against Live Exports, work tirelessly to end this inhumane trade. These male calves are the unwanted byproducts of the dairy industry. To produce milk, cows must have calves. But half their calves are male, the wrong gender for milk production. Furthermore, many of these male dairy calves are now purebred Holsteins, often regarded as producing poor quality beef. However, things are changing. Farmers are increasingly rearing male dairy calves for beef here in the UK. Others, however, still shoot their male calves at birth or export them to the continental veal units. We call on farmers to neither shoot their calves nor to export them, but instead to rear them humanely here at home. We also call on the government to take the lead in persuading our EU partners to place a maximum limit of 8 hours on journeys to slaughter or for fattening.